I came through Tuscaloosa, I would eat at Dreamland. It's just like, you have to do it.
When you first come up, you kind of go, whoa, hey, is this place as good as what they say? It's not about the outside, it's about what's happening on the inside.
I have a rule about barbecue restaurants that you never go to one to eat unless you see smoke coming out of a smokestack and smell the hickory smoke. All I have to do is get in the neighborhood and follow the aromas.
The Dreamland story is really quite simple. We were founded in 1958 by a gentleman by the name of John Big Daddy Bishop.
Daddy was a brick mason, and him and his buddies was trying to decide what to do. So he wanted to open a mortuary and a barbecue place. You heard the story? And my mom told him he can't do that. You can't open a funeral home and a barbecue place right next door to each other. And he said, well, yes, we can. He said, we can make more money. They'll eat a lot of barbecue, and when they die, we'll bring them over to the funeral home. My mom said, no, I'm not going in with it. My mom said, if that's what you're going to do, I'm not going to do it.
With him being a brick mason, the focal point of his restaurant was the brick pit. And like a lot of neighborhood cafes, during that time, he served a lot of different things.
She had cheeseburgers, fish, all that stuff. But when it got to be so much, so she just started doing the ribs. All we had here was ribs and white bread. That was it. You didn't have nothing else but ribs and white bread.
All of our Dreamland locations are, we like to be part of the community, and we look at that as a community both inside the restaurant and outside the restaurant.
My dad, he wanted a place where a lot of blacks could come and have a fun that was safe and everything. And it got to be where he didn't tolerate no stuff in here. Everybody was just together. When you're in here, you family.
Well, Tuscaloosa and Alabama is all about tradition, right? And the tradition of Dreamland Barbecue kind of coincides with the tradition of Alabama football. 1958, Coach Bryant comes to Tuscaloosa to take over the Crimson Tide, and during Dreamland started up that same year. So as Coach Bryant built his dynasty on the football field, Big Daddy John Bishop kind of built his dynasty in the barbecue rib business.
So originally, back years ago, you didn't have the regionalized football coverage. So one of the ways Dreamland got so much notoriety was in the 70s when Alabama football was very prominent.
Memories of watching Alabama, where they only had one or two games a year on television.
Well, one of the first times I heard about it, of course, was Keith Jackson talking about it on television about when he came to town and him coming by here.
They'd be talking during the most exciting parts of the game sometimes, and they'd be talking about Dreamland.
And that started a groundswell of interest, and people started associating us with Alabama football, and just through the years that has continued.
You have to go to Dreamland if you're going to go to an Alabama football game in Tuscaloosa.
It's amazing that Alabama football and Dreamland go together the way they do. You think of Alabama football, you think of Dreamland ribs.